Welcome back. As promised, here you have my reading spreadsheet. But before I start explaining how I use it, I should give you some background information. In this spreadsheet, I keep all the books I've read since 2010. And I know most people prefer to create a different spreadsheet each year, but I don't. I prefer to have everything in a single spreadsheet so that I have not only the stats for the current year, but also I can easily analyze my reading over the years. So, as you may imagine, this spreadsheet has evolved a lot as my reading is, and as Excel itself has evolved over all those years. Now, that said, let's jump right in, shall we? First thing you should notice are those tabs here at the bottom. Now I have 6 different tabs. That means that I have 6 different sheets inside my main reading spreadsheet. I have the reading years, which is my book survey. Then I have a sheet for the books I buy, my stats, charts, projects, and reference tables. The first tab is the heart of my reading spreadsheet. It is where I keep the data, the books I've read over the years, and all the information about those books that I think it's important for me to analyze my reading. This sheet here is formatted as a table, and you will understand why I did that, because it gives me more flexibility to analyze the data. Let's see how I formatted the table. First column here is the title of the book, and I've frozen the column so that if I go on in the table, I have here with me always the title of the book, and it makes easy for me to input the information related to that specific book. So first column, title, author, type. Now, what does it mean? I created this column because I wanted not only to recall the books I read each year, but also if I read a standalone short story or a standalone poem or an interesting essay published in a magazine, I can also input this information here and have it recorded. So type is book, encyclopedia entry, essay, interview, magazine, short story, is it a thesis, and so on. Then literary form, nonfiction, novel, novella, play, poetry, short story. Genre, the genres I read most frequently. I have a list here. Number of pages, and once I input the number of pages, I have a formula that gives me the length of the book. It's around 100 and 199 pages. Publishing date, the year the book was originally published. That means that I input the year the book, let's say I'm reading a book in translation, I input here the year the book was originally published in its original language. And once I input the year, I have a formula that gives me the decade, like between 2010 and 2019. Then the format, is it audiobook, ebook, hardback, paperback? Which is the source of the book, my TBR, was it borrowed from a friend, library book, or review copy? My rating, the date I started the book, the date I finished the book, And once I input the data finished, I have a formula that gives me the month and the year in which I read that book. And as you can see here, I've marked only the books to show you, only the books I've read in 2018. I could have marked all the years for my data, but I decided to show only 2018 because it's easier for me in the future when I have to add the books I continue reading this year. It's easier for me. Then the status, is it a first time read, a reread, or a DNF? Did I reveal this book on my blog, yes or no? So all those columns here are related to the book, are about the book, and I have now a series of columns about the author. So gender, nationality, continent, and now I have some columns which are table columns which will be important when I build my pivot tables in my stats. So yeah, this is the main table. The reason why I formatted it as a table, it's because I can easily research some information here. Let's say I want to know all the books I've read since 2010. And let's say I want to see all the books I've read by a particular author. Let's say I want to see all the books I've read by Julio Cortazar. Then I look here, it's in alphabetical order. I mark here, and the table gives me all the books I've read by him. Okay, that's all about my main sheet. Now I have a fairly new sheet here, which I created at the start of 2018 to record all the books I buy in the future. So here I have also formatted it as a table, and here the date I bought the book, title, author, genre, because then I can analyze my TBR according to this information. Genre, number of pages, then formula to give me the length of the book, the format, is it paperback, hardback, ebook, is it used or new, secondhand, new, where did I buy the book, was it online, was it in a physical store, the cost of the book, the date I've read the book. Now once I input on the previous sheet a book and the date I've read, if this table here find the same book listed here as a book I've bought in 2018, it will automatically give me the date I've read the book. The status, is it still TBR, is it read, how many years since I bought the book, how many years it took me to read it, how many years until it was read. Here I read those two books in less than a year, and these ones here were not read yet. The month I've bought the book, the year I've bought the book, and the year I've read, and here the number of books, which will be important for my stats. Now my third and most interesting spreadsheet. Here I have my stats, and I decide to have my stats in pivot tables. because pivot tables are very easy to use and very flexible as well. The sky is the limit for you to create a pivot table with different combinations of those columns here. Let's see what I make of it. First, I have stats about my authors. And the first pivot table here, it's about my most read authors. So you have listed here in the order of most read to least read, all the usual suspects, all the authors I've read the most since 2010, logically. Then another table about the nationality and continent where those authors come from. And you can see this information for each year, 2017, 16, 15, 14, and I'll decide to show only the most recent year. Now I have all the countries I've read this year and the percentage of, yeah, of those countries in my reading this year. Now I have a table only for the nationality, also organized for each year. All this information in those two tables here, nationality and continent, you can find in this previous table here. But I wanted a specific pivot table so that I can have more specific charts, and I'll show you them next. So I have nationalities, the most read nationalities each year, the most read continents each year, the most read countries since 2010. Also the usual suspects here. Now, genders, the gender I read the most, also organized for each year, the most read gender since 2010. Now I have a group of tables about the books. Here I have a table about the most read books according to literary form and genre, also organized per year. If I can click here, I can have the information about 2016, 15, and so on and so forth. So the literary forms and genres I read the most. And here also these two tables here, you can find this information in the first table, but I wanted separate tables for literary form and genre so that I can have a specific chart as well. Same thing, the most read literary forms each year, the most read genres each year. Then the books organized by publishing date, which are the decades I read most books from, and also according to the different years. Then the size of the book, the format, the source, and that's it. So that I can have all my stats for all the years. Now I have a group of tables about my reading, how many books, the average of pages, minimal number of pages, maximum number of pages, the sum of pages for each month in each year. So I can compare. Then I have number of books by month, also for each year, number of pages by month, my rating, also organized by month and over the different years. And here my average rating monthly. My rereads, first reads and DNFs, how many books I reread, read for the first time or DNF in a particular year, and the total things I've read, counting not only books but also standalone essays, short stories, articles, poems that I read that are published in magazines, for example. Then I have a group of tables about my reviews. Now, which nationalities I review the most on my blog and for each year that I've been writing about books. Which countries I've written about on my blog. To which gender belong the authors I'm reviewing on my blog. Are they mostly female? Are they mostly male? The literary forms and genres I am reviewing on my blog. What do I review the most over the years? Total literary forms that I reviewed on my blog. Total genres since 2010. When were published the books that I reviewed on my blog? And in total, when were those books published? So that I can compare this information about the books I'm reading and the books I am reviewing. Is there a difference between the books I read the most and the books I review the most? So I can have these stats as well. Here I have a group of tables about my TBR. The year I bought the books and the year those books were read. So for instance, I bought 25 books in 2018 and 5 of those 25 were read in 2018, and the next 20, I don't know yet. They will be read in the future. My TBR since the beginning of the year, 20 books bought in 2018 that are not read yet. The genres I buy books the most, the formats I buy books the most, what's the size of the books I'm reading, and how many years are those books, how many years those books are on my TBR still unread. Then a group of stats about the books I am buying. If I buy mostly used or new books, where do I buy them from? How much do they cost? What was the total cost of the books I've already read? And what's the total cost of the books that I haven't read yet? This I build with formula. Then by month, when did I buy the books? So yeah, those are my stats. Now I have my charts, and they are also divided about according to the topic. Now the first charts are about the authors I am reading, and here you have, for example, the continent they come from, divided according to the different years I've been reading. Now I can select only the current year here. So let's say I want to see the graphic only for 2018, and I have this information. Let's say I want to compare 2018 with 2017, and I have it here. So I like the flexibility that the pivot chart gives me, like the pivot table also gives me some flexibility. Nationality, I can do the same thing. Let's say I want only the countries of the books I've read this year. So they are here. Here I have a map with all the countries I've read books from since 2010. The most read countries since 2010. The most read gender since 2010. And here, according to the different years, let's say I want to see only the current year, I can mark here. And there you have it. Now I have my graphs about the books, the most read literary forms in since 2010. So you have here 2018, 17, and so on and so forth. Let's say I want to read to see the graph for 2018. And there you have it. Same thing for the genres. I want to see, I want to compare 2018 and 2017. Ta-da, that you have the information. Publishing date, same thing. Now, I want to see only current year. Yeah, I'm reading mostly, I'm reading mostly contemporary books. Format, let's see, let's compare the current year and the previous year. And there you have it, I'm reading paperbacks the most. Where do I get my books? Let's see here. I want to see only 2018, 2017, 2016. And you can see 2016, 17, 18. Now I have a series of graphics about my reading. How many books I read a month since 2010. I can just select 2018 and see how many books I read so far. Also, how many pages a month. Let's select 2018, 2017, and then you have the information. It's very interesting. I really like this one, my average rating. It's pretty much stable here, but let's choose only, let's see, 2018, 17, 16. And you have here the books I've reviewed, how many of them. Now I can choose to follow here. My rereads. You see, I don't reread much. It's not my thing. Now, my graphs about my reviews. Which countries I'm reviewing books from? Mostly United States and England. I should change that. Which literary forms I'm reviewing the most. Yeah, to which decades belong the books I review on my blog. The genres I'm reviewing the most. Here, interesting thing, that's the map of the countries I've reviewed books from. And you can see it's very limited. Even more limited than the map I'm reading books from. So yeah, I should change that on my blog. And here my most reviewed authors, the authors I write most about on my blog, and the usual suspects. But you can also see that this is very different from the table of my most read authors. So that's another thing I should change. My next sheet are my projects, my long-term projects. This is also a sheet I created at the start of 2018. So I have here my Persephone Books project. I want to read all the books published by Persephone. So I created a table where I input the title, the author, the year I read this book, if I reveal the book, and the number of books. So all the books, the Persephone books I've read so far. Here you have the stats. So far they have published this amount of books. I've only read 8 and I have this still to read. It's automatic. Once I input the book on the previous table here, then this table is automatic. The percentage of what I've read, what is still to read, total of books I've read, from these how many have I written about, how many have I still to write about, and the percentages. Now, when did I read those books? So here I have the years, my current progress, the percentage of books I've written about and have yet to write about, and the amount of books I've read each year that I'm doing this project. Now the following projects follow the same scheme. Have Classics Club project, how many books I've read from my list, title, author, the year I've read, if I reviewed the book, and the number of books. I have this amount of books on my list. From this amount, I've read this amount. I am still to read these, and this is the percentage of books I've read and of books I have yet to read. This is the total I've read. From these, this is the total I've written about. I am still to write about 15 books. So this is the percentage of books I've written about, and this is the percentage I've still to read. Same thing here. How many books from this list I've read each year, my progress so far, the percentage of books reviewed and yet to be reviewed, and the number of books read per year belonging to this challenge. Next project is my Virago Modern Classics. Same thing. From the list, I input the ones I've read, title, author, the year I've read, if I reviewed, and the book, the number of books I read. Here is the total list, the number of books I've read, the number of books I'm still to read, and percentage. From the books I've read, this is the number I've written about, I am still to write about, 23 of the books I've read, the percentage of books revealed, the percentage of books yet to be revealed. This is my progress so far, the amount of books read each year, number of books written about, and number of books read each year. Then my Century of Books project. I've talked about this project in the last video. I'm taking it as a long-term project, and here are the title of the books, the year they were originally published, author, the year I read, if I reviewed, and the number of books. Total are 100. I've read 6. I'm still to read 94. Percentage read, percentage to read. From the total I've read, the number of books I've written about, books that are still to be written about, percentage reviewed, percentage to review. Progress so far, number of books per year, and number of books reviewed to review, number of books per year. Now I have some series I'm reading. So I have them here so that I can control that I complete the series. This series is ongoing. I can also mark here when I have completed it or DNF'd, stopped reading the series. Here I have a list of all the books in this series, and I mark the ones I've read, the year I've read those books, if I wrote a review, and the number. Here, same scheme, total books in the series, how many I read, how many still to read, the percentages from the total read, how many I've written about, how many I have to read about, and the percentages, my progress so far, how many books I've read each year, how many books I've written about, and how many books each year. I started this series this year, that's why I only have 2018. Then I have another series ongoing, all the books, the ones I've read, the year I've read them, if I wrote a review, and the number of books, how many are still to read, how many I am still to write about. I don't think I'm writing about this series though, because I'm not enjoying it. And I don't know why I'm reading it, but I want to complete it. This is my progress so far. The number of books I read each year. Here, another series by the same author, which I don't know why I'm reading, but I want to complete it. But I am enjoying it even less than the previous series. Here are all the books, the ones I've read, the year I've read them, if I wrote a review or not, how many are still to be read, how many are still to be written about, if I ever do that, my progress so far, and the books read per year. Then I have my final ongoing series of books, which this one I'm loving. All the books in the series, the ones I've read, when I have read them, if I wrote a review, how many books are still to be read, the percentages, how many books I've reviewed, the percentages, books per year, my progress so far. And that's it. Now my final tab, and this video is too long already, is the reference tables, which I use in my mostly in my main tab, so that I know which categories to choose from when I am inputting the information here. For instance, literary fiction here. All those categories are to be found here on my reference tables, and so on and so forth. Yeah, I can't believe it. I came to the end of this very long video. I hope it was not too boring for you. If you have any questions or suggestions, please let me know in the comments. Very curious to know how you record your reading, if you have a spreadsheet, if you use Goodreads, how you do it. I'll link some videos in the info box for some inspiration in case you want to create a similar spreadsheet. And if you have any questions how to do that, of course, you can leave me those questions in the comments. And I'll also try to write on my blog, on the post I will publish this video, I'll write about my stats for the year 2018 so far. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye!